After understanding the diagram, let us understand what is the torque on a current loop in a system like this. So torque on a rectangular current loop. So we have already seen this is a rectangular loop and current is flowing inside this loop and the magnetic field is uniform magnetic field. So magnetic field direction is always from north to south. So this is the direction of the magnetic field and it is a uniform magnetic field. That means magnetic field everywhere is same B. Magnetic field everywhere is same B. So that is called uniform magnetic field. So current in this loop is I. We can see that current flowing in this loop is I. And this is the direction of current. First here, then here, and then comes back. This is the direction of the current. So this is placed in uniform magnetic field and this will experience a torque. So we have already discussed that it will experience a torque similar to a dipole in an electrostatic field, but it does not experience a net force. That we will see later why it does not experience any force and will experience a torque. This behavior is analogous to the electric dipole in uniform electric field. So we have already seen that the electric dipole tries to rotate itself in uniform electric field. So this is a very similar situation to that. Here this loop will try to rotate itself in the magnetic field. So we have already seen that this is the rotational axis of this dipole. Along with about it, it will rotate. This is the north side, this is the south side. So this is the direction of the magnetic field B. This is the here, this is the direction of the current. Here this is in the opposite direction. Now please remember there is one more quantity shown here that we will see later. What is this M? What is this M? Again this is in bold, that means it is a vector quantity. So we will later see what is this M. So this thing is connected to a battery. This is a rectangular loop. This side is A, this side is B. Area of this loop is AB. That we know. The area of rectangle is length into width. So let us first consider the simple case when rectangular loop is placed such that the uniform magnetic field B is in plane of the loop. So we can see that the plane of this loop is also same and magnetic field is in the same plane. So first, in the first case, the direction of the magnetic field and plane both are in the same direction. So this is the first case. We will see a general case later where there is some angle between this plane. So this is at some angle and magnetic field will remain same. That we will see later. What is that case? So first case is simple. When this loop and magnetic field both are in same plane. Now the field exerts no force on two arms AD and BC. So let us see, there are two arms, this one arm and this another arm. So these two arms BC and this AD, they will experience no force because their direction is parallel to the direction of the magnetic field. This is direction of the magnetic field, this is BC and this is AD. So the direction of the magnetic field is same or parallel, and in case of parallel, theta is equal to 0. So sine theta is also 0. So these two arms, this upper arm and the lower arm, will not feel any force. So there are no force on these two arms. Now this arm and this arm will experience a force. It is perpendicular to the arm AB, so of the loop, and exerts force F1 on it. So we can see that if we see this arm and this arm, these two arm. So let us take one by one. Let us take first arm, this AB. So current is going in this direction. Arm is in this direction. So magnetic field is perpendicular to this. Magnetic field and arm are perpendicular to this. So that means it will experience some kind of force, and that force is force F1, and F1 is given as F1 is equal to I B into B. So we know force is equal to I L cross B. So this was force that we know. So we know this direction of this length can be transferred on the direction of current. So this is the direction of the current. This is the direction of the magnetic field. So definitely they are making a 90 degree angle. So angle is 90 degree, theta is equal to 90 degree, and you know that for 90 degree angle sine theta is equal to 1. So we can simply change this thing as force F1 magnitude. Now we are talking about magnitude, not the direction. So this I L, L is equal to B, length of this is equal to B into magnetic field B. So I B into B. So this is the force on this AB arm. Now let us see another arm. What will happen in case of this another arm? This arm DC or CD. So we will have force F2 on this arm CD. But if you see, the direction of the current is just opposite. Direction of the current is like this, and magnetic field is in this direction. So that means force will be, magnitude of the force will remain same. The current is I, again the length is same B, and magnetic field is also uniform B. So the magnitude of the force will remain same, which is equal to F1, but the direction is opposite. The direction of this force is opposite. So this force F1, which is directed into the plane of the loop. So this first force is directed into the plane of the loop, and this F2 is directed out of the plane of the paper. So this F2 is directed out of the plane of the paper, and this first one F1 is directed into the plane of the loop or plane of paper. So the direction is opposite, but the magnitude remains same. The net force on the loop is zero, because net force is vector sum of the forces F1 plus F2, the vector sum. And we know this F1 is equal to minus F2, that we know. So net force is zero. Both forces are equal, but the direction is opposite, so one will become minus and F1 is equal to F2, so net force on this loop is zero. But again, if there is zero force, that does not mean torque is also zero. So this force is F2, so this is in this direction, and this F1 is in this direction. Now let us take this to be middle point of this. And again we can see a quantity small m here. So we will learn what this quantity is, but for now let us see this point. So this total distance is a, so that means a by 2 on this side and a by 2 distance on this side, which is shown here, a by 2 this side and a by 2 this side. So now let us see what would be the torque. So there is no net force there, but there is a torque on the loop due to the pair of forces. So we know if net force is zero, that does not mean torque is zero. If there is a pair of forces and both are in opposite direction and equal in magnitude, they will try to rotate this system. So now let us calculate the what is the torque. So we know formula of torque is tau is equal to R cross F. Again, so what is the distance? Distance R is equal to A by 2, and this force is F1. F1 और एफ टू बोथ वर इक्वल टू एफ इज इक्वल टू आई बी इंटू बी. सो दिस वॉज द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ. अगेन सिंस वी कैन सी दिस द डायरेक्शन हैज 90 डिग्री एंगल, सो दिस आर क्रॉस एफ विल बी सिंपली आर एफ, बिकॉज साइन 90 इज इक्वल टू साइन थीटा और साइन 90 इज इक्वल टू 1. सो लेट अस पुट दिस वैल्यू. सो टॉर्क इज फॉर द फर्स्ट वन, सो टोटल टॉर्क फॉर फर्स्ट वन द फोर्स एफ वन इंटू डिस्टेंस ए टू, सो एफ वन इंटू ए बाई टू. अगेन दिस सेकेंड फोर्स एफ टू इंटू डिस्टेंस ए बाई टू. सो सम ऑफ बोथ दीज फोर्सेस. नाउ लेट अस पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एफ वन. एफ वन इज आई बी इंटू बी, एफ टू इज ऑल्सो आई बी इंटू बी. सो दिस ए बाई टू एंड ए बाई टू बिकम्स ए. सो वॉट वी हैव इफ वी टेक कॉमन दिस आई बी एंड बी, सो दिस ए बाई टू प्लस ए बाई टू विल बिकम ए. सो वॉट वी हैव आई बी बी इंटू ए. नाउ लेट अस टेक दिस ए एंड बी इन साइड वन ब्रैकेट. दिस ए एंड बी विल बिकम कैपिटल ए, वेयर कैपिटल ए इक्वल टू ए बी इज द एरिया ऑफ द रेक्टेंगल. सो टॉर्क इज सिंपली आई ए बी, वेयर आई इज द करेंट इन द लूप, ए इज द एरिया ऑफ द लूप एंड बी इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड.